Today we're going to talk about 5 mistakes that you must not make during the no contact rule. Last month, I went through my private Facebook support group to look at the biggest mistakes that people were making during the no contact rule. I looked at hundreds, if not thousands, of people's mistakes, and 5 clear patterns emerged. And today, I'm gonna let you in on what each of those patterns is and how you can avoid it. But if you're looking for a starting place or even just starting to consider getting an ex back, the first place I would recommend for you to go is to hop by my website, www.exboyfriendrecovery.com, to take my ex recovery chances quiz. It's a simple 2 to 3 minute quiz that's designed to answer one singular question. What kind of chance do you have of getting your ex back? We look at lots of different factors using your answers and give you a unique score so that you can figure out what you should be doing. Now, if you're interested in taking the quiz, it is super simple. All you have to do is simply look at the description link below this YouTube video and click on it, and we'll get you hooked up. All right, let's get started and talk about some of those mistakes. Mistake number 1, deleting your ex off of all social media platforms. I'm a big fan of something called the active no contact rule. Most people falsely believe that all you have to do to win an ex back is enact a no contact rule and wait around for your ex to come back. That couldn't be further from the truth. In fact, I would argue that how much work you put in during your particular no contact rule is going to coincide with how successful you are at getting your ex back. So what do I mean when I talk about deleting an ex off of all social media? Well, there seems to be this insane belief that after a breakup, you should just cut off all ties and all ways for an ex to contact you. You block them on Facebook, get rid of them on Snapchat or Instagram. But how are they going to find out all of the amazing things that you're doing in your life during your no contact period if they don't have any way of seeing that? Remember, an active no contact rule is one in which you are doing active things outside of focusing on your ex. You're going swimming, you're going out with friends, partying, going to new places, reshaping your ex's belief system about how you are. If he or she has no way of seeing these changes, what's it matter? Mistake number 2, do not confide in your ex's friends or family. Ah, now here is where we start to get controversial. Maybe you have a good relationship with your ex's mutual friends or his family, but one thing that you need to always understand is that they're always going to be on his side. They're never going to be on your side. No matter how much they tell you that they are, we have consistently seen the opposite is true. Oftentimes, when you confide in your ex's friends or family, information can get to him that you don't really want to get to him. Mistake number 3, do not obsess over their social media or stalk them. Hey, I get it. You've just gone through a breakup, you're obsessing about them 24/7. Why not just look at their social media profile? Why not just sort of hop on over to their school or work to see what they're up to, see who they're talking to? But this is a bad idea. In fact, researchers have consistently found that going through a breakup is kind of like going through a withdrawal period if you're a drug addict. The same part of the brain functions when a crack addict, for example, is going through withdrawal. You're experiencing a lot of the same physical and emotional symptoms. Your ex is a drug, so it makes complete sense that you want to see what they're up to or stalk them, but we have found that that actually opens up an avenue to not only breaking the no contact rule, but doing something really, really stupid and hurting your overall chances of getting them back. Mistake number 4, do not talk to your own friends or family about wanting your ex back. If you've decided that you want to use a no contact rule on your ex or you want to get them back, you're probably in the minority when you look at society as a whole. In fact, most people believe you should never get back with an ex. Why would you ever want to do that? But the ironic part is society also throws their support behind people who keep marriages together when they're breaking up. They're kind of the same thing, except they elicit two separate reactions. Now, I often find that when you're trying to get an ex-boyfriend back and you talk to your own friends or family about it, they're not as supportive as you might think. In fact, many times they will try to convince you not to follow a no-contact rule and try to say, why would you ever want an ex back? They're not going to give you the support that you're hoping to get. Let's not also forget that pesky fact that if you confide in one of your best friends and they go off script and tell your ex what you're doing, it's not going to really help your overall situations. And before you think, oh, that would never happen to me, I am pulling this from my private Facebook group where this exact kind of thing has happened. Mistake number 5, only focusing on your ex's interests instead of your own. Now, most people who come to me are obsessed with getting back with their exes. They only think about a potential future relationship together. They only focus on their ex's point of view instead of their own point of view. Now, that sounds weird, I know, but think about it when it comes to conversations or even simple thoughts. If you're only thinking about your ex's interest, or you're only thinking about what your ex is thinking, you're gonna not have any time to do the internal work that you need to do to be successful or even be attractive to him. You may have heard me talk a lot about this idea of an ungettable girl, this sort of girl that a man can never quite wrap his hands around. He can never quite get to commit. He's always chasing. She's always unobtainable. Now, one interesting fact about ungettable girls is they don't obsess about what the men are thinking about. They don't obsess about what is he doing? Why isn't he texting me? They're too busy to even care. You may have also heard me talk about this concept of being willing to lose the guy. Often, if you're willing to lose the guy, you're gonna get the guy. Hey, thank you so much for getting to the end of the video. You made it through all 5 mistakes. Hopefully you didn't make any of them. Now, if you haven't already and you're figuring out if you want to get your ex back, my best recommendation for you is to hop over to my website, www.exboyfriendrecovery.com, and figure out what kind of chance you have of getting your ex back. You can simply do that by looking in the description link below, click on that link, and it will take you directly to a quiz that will ask you a bunch of questions and figure out what kind of chance you have of getting your ex back. So again, look below, click on the link you see there, and we'll hook you up. The next thing, if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel. Subscribe and click the bell notification so that you can get updates anytime I come out with a new video or answer your comments. I'll see you guys next time.